Hello, everybody. My name is Sebastian. I've been producing music for about 5 years now, but I've been more serious about it for the past year and a half. Today, I will be talking about the different types of microphones and how they work. First of all, let's just remind us what a microphone is. A microphone is an input transducer. It transforms one kind of energy into another, or in our case, it converts sound pressure variations into voltage variations, also known as an audio signal. We'll be talking about two kinds of microphones in this video. First of all, the dynamic microphone, which is great for on-stage performance. It isolates the sound source, which is great for loud environments, and it's very robust, so we don't have to fear about it breaking. We will also be talking about the condenser microphone. Condenser microphones are great for studios. They are very sensitive and will replicate the sound recorded very accurately. However, you will need to power this using phantom power or 48 volts. Let's start with the dynamic microphone. A dynamic microphone works by electromagnetic induction, which means it uses a magnet to generate the electrical current. In the head of the microphone, there's a diaphragm, usually made out of plastic or rubber, which will receive the sound waves. Attached to the diaphragm is an induction coil or wire, and when the diaphragm vibrates, the coil goes into the magnetic field of a magnet, which creates an electrical current, your audio signal. This also explains why a dynamic microphone does not need an external source of power to function, because it's generating its own power. However, one diaphragm won't be able to accurately reproduce every audio frequency, and some microphones will use multiple diaphragms for different frequencies and then combine all of these frequencies as one single audio signal. This option is quite expensive and rare, and that's why you'll most commonly see dynamic microphones specialized for certain frequencies, for example, for bass or for vocals. Let's talk about the condenser microphone now. The condenser microphone uses two metal plates to create an electrical current. One of these plates is a diaphragm, which will vibrate to the sound waves hitting it, and the other plate is stationary, meaning it doesn't move at all. An electrical source provides current, which will pass through the plates and create an electrical field between the plates. This electrical source used to be a battery, but today it is much more common for condenser microphones to use phantom power. As the diaphragm vibrates, the electrical field changes, which results in your audio signal. This explains why condenser microphones are better for studio uses. If the amplitude of the sound waves hitting the diaphragm is too big, the two metal plates could touch and ruin the microphone. And since in a studio environment, the total amplitude is usually not as high as on a stage, it's much more or less likely for a condenser microphone to reach that threshold which could damage the microphone. Thanks for listening to my tutorial on microphones and how they work. I hope you learned something and have a nice day.